People want food that tastes delicious. And I don't care how sustainable, how healthful food is. If it isn't tasty, I don't want it.
I'm Bryant Terry, and I'm a chef, a food justice activist, and an author of 3 cookbooks.
I'm currently working on a new book that'll be out in 2014. And when I'm working on a book project, I feel like it's important for me to kind of live and breathe the subject. So even when I'm not writing, I'm always thinking about the subject. I'm constantly going to farmers markets. I'm going to urban farms or to the nursery to get starts. I'm really looking for the freshest, most local ingredients to use, because the reality is that food tastes the best. I truly need a car to do the work that I do, because I'm writing cookbooks. I need ingredients. And having a compact car makes navigating parking so much easier, because that thing can fit into some small spaces. I actually started off as a grassroots activist working in New York City with young people. I was deeply concerned that many communities simply didn't have access to healthy, affordable, fresh food. So I wanted to really help them think about what they were eating, where their food came from, how it was affecting their personal health and well-being. And in the beginning, there were days when I was going out and doing these workshops, and they said that they don't want to hear about, you know, food that they don't like. But I think the thing that kept me going is this sense of urgency. It's really a personal mission. It's really about me wanting to prolong the life of the people that I care about.
How many community gardeners, home gardeners, are next?
There are people who argue that eating local sustainable food is just kind of the passing fad, but these are things that my grandparents were doing decades ago.
When we first moved into our home, within a week, we built this 100 square foot raised bed garden in the front, and it was really symbolic. We don't need grass, we need food.
We're growing everything from collard greens to mustard greens to kale to broccoli, and we pretty much eat out of it every day. If you're growing fresh herbs in your windowsill, if you're just growing some tomatoes in a pot, it is making a difference.
Writing books is something that I'm always gonna do, but the most powerful and effective way of engaging with people around these issues is face-to-face contact.
It makes me feel like I'm truly doing the work that I was put here to do. I feel hopeful.
For that funky village. For that funky village.